How we doing this morning? You guys know what day it is today, right? What day is it? Wow. This is fantastic. Listen, every time I come out here, I just have to thank you guys for being such a gracious host to our artists. And it's just wonderful to have us all here at the same time, especially celebrating Martin Luther King's birthday, you know? Over the years, though, I've found that black history is every day, not just one day, okay? So let's get an amen to that. So without further ado, I'm going to bring out our host for today, Mr. Clifton Davis.
Thank you, Tony. Thank you so much. Tony Cornelius, all right?
Yeah.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Hope you had a good night's rest, rocking and rolling on the sea, soothing you to sleep. We are here to celebrate Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., and we're also celebrating Curtis Mayfield. How many remember Curtis Mayfield? Keep on pushing and moving on up all of the good stuff that he did back in the day. And, I've been around a while. I know I carry a youthful expression, like so many of you. To our white friends, black don't crack. I just had to tell you that. You don't mind if I share that with you. You got that, Don? But Don been with the black folks so long, he don't crack either. But I've been around a long time. Here's a video that I want to show you on the screen of me and Curtis Mayfield 50 years ago.
Listen to the prophet poets of black people sing the rhythms of ancient Africa. Your melodies call my Aunt Ollie, my Aunt Clara, and my Uncle Art out of the plantation cotton field. Your chants are the proud songs of rebellion that our fathers sang from the bowels of desolation ships during the Middle Passages. Your songs are of Harlem and Watts, and of pompadours and provoduses, and conks and gases and marcels and dews and of naturals. And every time you open your mouths, you sing and caress our souls, being beautiful black birds, making love to black people with every word. You cry for junkies and bougies and whores and debs and babies without fathers. The stories you tell take our heroes out of the jails and put them on the thrones in our hearts. And people, we must get ready. People, get ready. You must believe me that as we grow closer together, the sad, sad girl and boy, you and I, the minstrel and the queen, I'm so proud that every brother is a leader and every sister is a breeder, cause we got to keep on pushing. Yeah. It's all right with me. Yes, it is. It's all right with me that we're a winner, cause this is our country and your souls belong to our people.
This is my country.
How about that? Huh? Isn't that something? mercy. Well, before we get started, I want you to invite Paula Holloway and everybody else up here on the stage to sing a little song before we get going this morning. Is that all right? All right. Give it up for her. Still be here by God's grace. I used to be kind of fine. Time catches up with everybody, doesn't it? But it's all right. It's all right. Curtis Mayfield, what a man he was. In fact, his music was the soundtrack for the civil rights movement. And so we're honored to pay tribute to Curtis Mayfield for his soul music and for his spirit of freedom and liberty that he transferred through his music to the people of America. We pay tribute to Curtis Mayfield, but we celebrate the holiday, the life, and the legacy of the drum major for freedom, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Give it up to him. Great man of God who sacrificed his life for the cause of freedom. Over in the Bible, in the book of Genesis, Genesis, the 50th chapter and the 25th verse, I believe it is, the story is told about Joseph, the son of Jacob, who was sold into slavery and then went to Potiphar's house and got thrown into prison and rose up to be the prime minister of Egypt. And in the 50th chapter, it's near the end of Joseph's life. And he said, God will come and aid you. And when he does, I want you to bring my bones with you to the promised land. He's going to honor his word to you, and I want you to remember me and bring my bones with you out of this land into the promised land. Well, I came today to say we need to wave the banner for freedom, but bring the bones. Bring the bones. We're looking at a world that has changed dramatically from the time when Dr. King was doing his thing. I remember his words that live in my heart like the Liberty Bell rang with a riveting message of hope that was heard around the world. His world, his noble words that earned the Nobel Peace Prize, his noble words, we recall those words that galvanized a nation to transform its laws and to reinterpret its creed that all men are created equal. The number one song along the freedom rides, the number one sing-along on the freedom rides was Keep On Pushing, the Curtis Mayfield composition that inspired and fired up the civil rights campaign crowd. Dr. King often used Mayfield's People Get Ready with all its incisive lyrics as the music to move his marchers, and he named it the movement's unofficial anthem, precisely because of its motivational and inspirational effect. Brothers and sisters, this morning I want to share with you that Dr. King dared to dream, and he shared that dream. His words inspired generations of disenfranchised people, and it was there in Washington, D.C., that he said, we have also come to this hallowed spot to remind America of the fierce urgency of now. This is no time to engage in the luxury of cooling off or to take the tranquilizing drug of gradualism. Now is the time to make real the promises of democracy. Those were his words. So today, Soul Train crews, join me as we commemorate his life, not only with this celebration of the influence and profound impact of Curtis Mayfield on the movement, not only by the national holiday named in Dr. King's honor, not only by his likeness chiseled in stone on the National Mall, but by the reality of expanded freedom in America. We need to wave the flags, the banner for freedom, but bring the bones. Don't ever forget where we came from. Don't ever forget our history. Don't ever forget the struggle we went through. Don't ever forget the war
prisons. Don't ever forget the dogs. Don't ever forget the jailings. Don't ever forget what we went through. While we enjoy the cruise today, we need to tell our children what happened back in the day. Wave the banner, but bring the bone. Curtis Mayfield performed the soundtrack of the civil rights movement, and Dr. King beat the drums. Somebody say amen. And it's because of his nonviolent social protests and his civil rights advocacy that the world in which we live in is changed. We need to wave the banner for this new world. Today, equal rights under the law have been public policy since 1964. Thank you, Dr. King. Wave the banner. Legalized segregation in public education is a thing of the past. Thank you, Dr. King. Black patrons don't have to sit in a balcony to see a movie in Memphis. Some of y'all remember that. Or to attend a predominantly white church. Thank you, Dr. King. Today, Holiday Inn, Hampton Inn, and Days Inn will let me in, and they leave the light on for me. Thank you, Dr. King. Wave the banner, but bring the bone. Today, black-owned business can and do go global, and black enterprise keeps us informed. Thank you, Dr. King. Today, African-American publishing is joined by Essence Environment, more than 250 newspapers and publications, including Oprah Magazine. Thank you, Dr. King. Wave the banner, everybody, but bring the bone. Today, we have had Ken Chenault at American Express, Carl Ware, Deputy Group President at Coca-Cola, Alfred T. Mays at Johnson & Johnson, Roger L. Plummer, President and CEO of Ameritech, A. Barry Rand at Xerox, Brenda Edgerton at Campbell Soup, Richard Manula at Walt Disney, I'm going to quote it all off, Johnny Furr at Anheuser-Busch, Gilroy Griffin at Bristol Myers Squibb. We've got Byron Allen at Entertainment Studio. We got Kathy Hughes on Radio One. Today we have corporate leaders who are black, and it happened because of Dr. King. Wave the banner, but bring the bone. Today, Sidney Poitier and Hattie McDaniel got a little company over at the Academy Awards. Louis Gossett Jr., Cuba Gooding Jr., Morgan Freeman, and Denzel Washington got two, and Halle Berry holds home, and Mahershala Ali, and Lupita Nyong'o, and Octavia Spencer, Jamie Foxx, Viola Davis, Forrest Whitaker, Jennifer Hudson. Put your hands together for the achievement of black people in the entertainment industry. Yes. Nowadays, Oscar can be occasionally seen wearing a black face, but he's not singing Mammy, and he's not holding a lantern on anybody's lawn. There's pride in that thing. Wave the banner for freedom, but bring the bones. Thank you, Dr. King. But still, as long as there are victims like Trayvon Martin, and Eric Garner, and Michael Brown, and little Sharice Iverson, we've still got a long way to go. As long as there's Charlottesville, we've still got a long way to go. But don't give up, folks. Wave the banner, but bring the bones. Keep on pushing. On the night before his death, Dr. King said, "We've got some difficult days ahead, but it really doesn't matter with me now because I've been to the mountaintop. I've looked over and I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land." And all along the way, Dr. King planted seeds of hope, and today that hope has has matured and yielded a harvest of new liberties. And as I stood before the King Memorial in Washington, D.C., I was touched and moved by remembrances of Dr. King's legacy, a legacy of love for God and for our fellow man. And because he lived, there's still hope. So we must go forward on that hope. We're waving the banner. Our freedoms are wonderful, but we've got a long way to go. So please, bring the bones. Day after day on his voyage to America, Christopher Columbus made the following determined entry in his diary. This day we sailed on. Day after day on his voyage to freedom, Martin Luther King Jr. sailed on, committed to his dream. He sailed on despite being locked in jail 29 different times. He sailed on despite the bombing of his own home. He sailed on despite the opposition and ridicule from both whites and blacks. He sailed on despite discouragement and setbacks. And this is how he put it. We're on the move now. The battle is in our hands. We are not satisfied, and we will not be satisfied until justice rolls down like waters and righteousness like a mighty stream. Wave the banner, but bring the bones. Let us never forget that there once lived a man named Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who was born on January 15th. 1929 on Auburn Avenue in Atlanta, Georgia. And at 15 years of age, he was accepted into Morehouse College. He graduated and he went on to Crozier Theological Seminary and then to Boston University, and then he did additional studies at Harvard University. Let us never forget that he was Time Magazine's Man of the Year in 1963. He won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1964. And let us never forget that the Martin Luther King Jr. Memorial is permanently erected in West Potomac Park next to the National Mall in Washington, D.C. And finally, let us never forget that on August 28, 1963, during a historic march on Washington, Dr. King inspired us and the world when he said, "I have a dream. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today." And he went on to say, "So let freedom ring from the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire. Let freedom ring from the mighty mountains of New York. Let freedom ring from the heightening Alleghenies of Pennsylvania. Let freedom ring from the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado. Let freedom ring from every hill and molehill of Mississippi. From every mountainside, let freedom ring." And when we let freedom ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of that old Negro spiritual, "Free at last, free at last, thank God Almighty, we are free at last." Wave the banner, but bring the
Show me your hands. Show me your hands. Show me your hands. Show me your hands. Dr. King, Smith, for us. Come on now. Show me your hands. Show me your hands.
I'm Y'all say God's good, ain't it? Yeah. Is it sometimes? Is it sometimes?
All the time.
Is it sometimes?
All the time.
I'll give a better king now.
You bet my seat.
All right, we got some more for you. We're honoring the legendary Curtis Mayfield. You enjoying it so far? We got some more for you. Thank you, thank you.
You know we love y'all, don't you?
How y'all doing? This next song I've always as a little kid wanted to count this off. Now I need y'all to help me out. My bass player's name is Terry. I need all y'all on the count of three to say hi to Terry. One more time, on three. One, two, three.
Hi, Terry.
Okay. His nickname is Butter. Because he's smooth like butter. Now, I'm explaining to y'all why. I'm going to get this count off, and I'm going to be able to take this off of my bucket list. All right? All right, so check this out. One, two, one, two, three, four.
Who gets so loud?
talk amongst yourselves. Sorry about that.
Talk amongst yourselves.
Here's today's topic.
One more time, y'all. Listen, again. I couldn't talk, she couldn't walk. So God is what? Come on now.
The musical definition of some grown man shit. Give it up for Mr. Lawrence doing on the lead vocal, y'all.
Yeah.
Soul Train.